Hello, good evening, welcome back. Friday, and it's 7th of August, an important day. I was kind of expecting the results for the app contest. Remember the app contest? Okay, the app contest, the government app contest in which I had participated sometime in the mid of last month. The results was supposed to be today, and yes, the result came, and apparently the announcement was a live event. It was streamed live on YouTube and Facebook. Very first short impression about this whole event: these government events are really pathetic. They just don't know how to run live streams. They just don't know how to manage. First probably 10 to 15 minutes people are speaking, there is no audio coming, the video quality was probably mediocre. Thirdly, that the people who are coordinating all those things, the live stream and all, they have not even bothered to mute themselves. They are just talking away to Dory in the backside, like, and it's all audible, and it's only their voice which is audible and not the presenter or whoever is talking. It is pathetic, I'll tell you. If you see such events, like being somebody from IT field and being somebody who sees such presentations day in and out, and for somebody who does a lot of such presentation, it's really embarrassing to see a government of India, a ministry of IT, I think that's what it is, right? They, a Digital India campaign and all those stuff, they're running a live stream in which the audio is pathetic and people are not on mute and they're just chatting away to Glory in the back, and it was so unprofessional, it was looking pathetic. Anyway, I just had to tell this. I mean, I just couldn't digest myself. Anyway, to the point, to the main point, no, I did not win the contest, and no regrets about it. I think I was confident that I will not win. I didn't want it to be like, I will win, I should figure out how to use this money and all those things. I was kind of sure that I will not win. That's fine. But a lot of learning from this particular contest, both the whole approach that we took and the lot of groundwork that I did. Frankly, the last 15 days I've not done anything, which I'm really sad about, but a lot of learning there. And even in today, after seeing the results, after seeing the presentations, a lot of learning. I think on the social media front, let me recollect, I think there was one app which was related to it's kind of like a microblogging, which is like a Twitter clone. To be very precise, it was a Twitter clone, but available in regional languages. So that is one of the things that won. And I'm not able to recollect what was the other two. But again, it was not something which is very, something which you can really post on, like that is new or anything. But apparently I had registered myself on this new so-called Twitter clone, the Desi Twitter clone, I would say. I'm supposed to be tweeting in that in Canada, but I just tried whatever possible. Like, it's difficult, like I'm not telling it's impossible, but it requires a different kind of a mindset. And the way I see it, the audience there are totally different. People who are like very much into this regional language thing, they are the type of people who are using it. So I'm kind of like, I don't know if that suits me or not, but I'll keep my account there. I'll leave it there. Once in a while, I'll just go and tweet some photo or anything. So that will be there. Anyway, having said that, they told like they will do a lot of subcategories, that this and all, and they were telling like some of the categories, the main categories got like few thousands of submissions, and I think social media got about 6,000 submissions or whatever. I don't know if it was overall or only this one, but no such subcategory was there. And the only other thing that had happened was regarding this others. They had given one prize. I think there were two or three prizes, and one of the eye-catchy one was Map My India. I think one of those map, kind of like a Desi version of Google Maps, which has far more features than what Google Maps gives. I think that's how it works. So that was one of the winners. So that's probably it. Like most of the others, the gaming ones, I don't know. I don't understand the gaming world. So I don't know if it is good, bad, or frankly speaking, from whatever little I've seen, PUBG ads and videos and all, the one of them looked exactly like that, but it's more of like a Desi version. and the business apps were like, the UI, the user experience looked close to awful. So I don't know if you can really call it as like an Amazon competitor, or you can call it as like a Flipkart competitor. The third one in the business category was the Zoho Books, which is like basically your financial bookkeeping kind of an app, which is there from quite some time. I'm surprising like they participated and they got a prize, which is good for them. I'm no regrets, but it's good. I've heard a lot of good things about them, and I know a lot of people who are using it also. So that was one of them. But if you really see those three, I think probably Zoho should have won first prize, but I don't know if that's like, how do they categorize this first, second, third, but Zoho was the third one. Zoho Books was the third one who gave the presentation. So that was the thing. So my learning was, the jury kind of expected a working app, a working application which is there in real world and people using it. And that is one thing. Second thing is, I mean, I think as I told you, like they want, it's not just a working app, which is like they wanted a working app in production. Like people should be using it. Real people should be using it. And all of these apps, I think all of these apps had somebody at one point or the other using it. So just good. The third thing is, I observed most of the apps, the way they are looking at it is like more people coming into this platform. Does it have that uniqueness, and does it have this attraction capability which will make more people coming into this app or platform or whatever? I think that is what they were expecting. So from my end, it was a concept, it was like a design, it was how it works, what is the benefit, what is the financial model and things like that. So in that way, I realized that I shouldn't have expected anything more. I didn't even get an acknowledgement, so that's fine. So a lot of good learnings from seeing all the things. I think I remember the social media, the first prize was a video, TikTok clone of India, I think. What was it called? Chingari or something. I don't remember. Probably it's Chingari. So it's basically a Desi version. I'm sorry, I'm using the word Desi frequently, but that's what they want. It's like digital India, made in India, and the way you tag everything is like, call it Desi. So it's a Desi version of TikTok, and I have seen that app, and I have seen that comment section, sorry, what is that? A review section also, and how people are bashing it left, right, and center. So anyway, we'll leave it there. So there is an option for public voting also, what app they like based on the demos that was given. Talking about demos, I think probably about 75-80% of the demos looked very unprofessional. Again, I'm bringing in that concept, but my bar is very high. I'm being very frank and honest. My threshold, my bar about this presentation, whole talking to the camera, talking to people, talking to the world, it's very high. If you can't make a good impression by doing such things, then it's not there. Now again, it might sound contradictory, or it might sound as an irony that these are the people who don't even know how to present. They're winning contest, and I'm sitting here who know how to do things, but it's, you can understand. But yeah, I can't let go of all this perfectionism stuff, what I would call, just because of such things. Anyway, some of them were like, the screen recording was done using softwares which had a big watermark on the thing, videos. Some people were just like, the way they keep the camera while recording, the audio was bad, and I don't know, one or two were good. Some of them, they had used stock images and stock footages and all. It was okay, but overall, I don't know. I think I saw only about 50% of them, and none of them impressed me at all. There was the learning app, the kids one, that was pretty good. It is helpful also. That's what I realized. I need to explore a little bit more. Most of them which I liked, I just written it down so that I can explore a little bit more on it. But anyway, to summarize, no, I didn't win the contest. No, this is not the end of the world. I am still planning to pursue it. I have just broken down that app structure into so granular part that I'm now thinking of getting it done like a very basic version of it. I think by now you should know that what I'm talking about. I'm just talking about app and all those stuff and social media. So it's basically, I want to do something like a MVP kind of a things, put it out, send it out to people, try to see if they can use it and all the stuff. So that is what is the plan, but I don't know when I'll start it because it requires money. So let's see. So that's a quick update about the Atmanirbhar app contest. That's it for today. I'll see you on Monday. Have a nice weekend. Bye-bye.